Deserts are often considered areas with very little life, but actually they're some of the most diverse ecosystems in California. Especially in desert ecosystems, when we think of the superblooms that create those carpets of color, those are usually done by the annual plants. A superbloom requires three components. First, in the late fall, sort of after the heat of the summer is done, you need a big rain. That rain needs to be big enough that it saturates the ground to reach all of the seeds that are in the seed bank. It's also important because it leaches out chemicals that are in the seed coat that are keeping that plant from germinating. The second piece is that you need to have consistent moisture throughout the winter. Not too much, not too little. The idea is that over the winter, these little tiny baby plants are beginning to grow and they're not being disturbed too much, so that in the spring, when they pop up above the ground, they're nice and healthy. The third piece is that once they do pop up above the ground, that there isn't any big environmental disturbance. For example, a big storm that can wash away sensitive little seedlings. They're also sensitive to predation by herbivores, and so they need to be in population numbers high enough to withstand all of that herbivore pressure. If you have those three things, then in the spring, when it gets nice and warm, those plants will start blooming. There's really lots of different organisms that are out there moving around and that rely on the plants. So when plants are doing well in a community, most other organisms in the community will be doing well too.